Hello friends, this is Dr. Janardhan Pawar. Once again, I welcome you all for one more video. In this video, we are going to talk about the MCQs of corporate accounting. And today, the topic which we are discussing is final accounts of company. Before that, first of all, I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, that is Academic Insights. If you like my channel, don't forget to subscribe it. Also press bell icon so that you'll get this kind of videos in days to come. Also like my videos, share my videos with your friends, colleagues and friends, and don't forget to write your comment in chat box. So friends, we are starting here. The topic which I have covered is company final accounts, and we are talking about the MCQs of corporate accounting paper 1. Friends, we are starting with question number 1. Question number 1 is here. Look at the question number 1. Share premium account is. Share premium account is a dash account, a real account, nominal account, impersonal account, personal account. These are the four options. And what is the correct option? Just look at this. The correct option is share premium account is a personal account. Question number 2. Minimum share capital of a public limited company is dash. Options are rupees 5 lakhs, rupees 1 lakh, rupees 10 lakh, rupees 4 lakhs. And the correct option is rupees 5 lakhs. Moving on to the question number 3. That is share premium account is shown in balance sheet under what? Share premium account is shown in balance sheet under dash heading or dash title. And the options are miscellaneous expenditure, current liabilities, reserves and surplus, none of the above. And the correct option is reserves and surplus. Question number 4. Premium received on issue of shares cannot be. The question number 4 is premium received on issue of shares cannot be utilized for. The options are distribution of dividend, issue of bonus shares, writing of preliminary expenses, and the last option, that is none of the above. And the correct option is distribution of dividend. Question number 5. Trade payables are recorded in. Trade payables are recorded in, and the options are asset side of balance sheet, profit and loss account, liability side of balance sheet, and last one, none of the above. And the correct option is liability side of balance sheet. Number 6, shares received from new company is recorded at. Shares received from new company is recorded at. Options are market value, fair value, average value, and the last one, none of the above. We are going to find out the correct answer, and the correct answer is market value. Question number 7. The company formed by the special act of legislature of parliament is known as. The company formed by the special act of legislature of parliament is known as. Options are public company, registered company, statutory company, chartered company. And the options are, and the correct option is, sorry, statutory company. Question number 8. Under which section of Companies Act 2013, a company can buy back its own shares? Under which section of Companies Act 2013, a company can buy back its own shares? And the options are section 68, section 61, section 82, and none of the above. And the correct answer is section 68. Question number 9. Goodwill in case of joint stock company is shown on the asset side of the balance sheet under the heading dash. Goodwill in case of joint stock company is shown on the asset side of the balance sheet under the heading dash. And the options are fixed assets, current assets, investments, and the last one, that is none of the above. And the correct answer for this question is fixed assets. Question number 10, expenses incidental to the creation and flotation of a company are called expenses incidental to the creation and flotation of a company are called. The options are underwriting expenses, preliminary expenses, trade expenses, establishment expenses. And the option and the correct option is preliminary expenses. Number 11. Section 198 of the Companies Act 2013 contains the provision relating to the manner of determination of net profit for the purpose of calculating the dash. And the options are disposal of net profit, managerial remuneration, fair value of shares, and fair value of assets. And the correct option is managerial remuneration. Question number 12. The amount of capital with which the company intends to get registered is known as. The options are issued capital, subscribed capital, authorized capital, called up capital. And the correct option is authorized capital. The portion of the authorized capital which can be called up only on the liquidation of the company is called as. Once again, I repeat the question. The portion of the authorized capital which can be called up only on the liquidation of the company is called as. And the options are authorized capital, reserve capital, issued capital, called up capital. And the correct option is called up capital. Question number 14. If shares are brought back out of free reserves, then a sum equal to nominal value of the shares so bought back is transferred to. And the options are capital reserve account, capital redemption reserve account, that is CRR, general reserve account, and the last one, statutory reserve account or reserve capital. So these are the options, and what will be the correct option that we are going to see. And the correct option is capital redemption reserve account, CRR. Number 15, profit and loss account shows the dash. Total capital employed, profit and loss through sale of assets, profit earned by company, and none of the above. And the correct option is profit earned by company. 16 number, the underwriting account is a dash account. And the options are a real account, nominal account, personal account, and none of the above. And the correct option for this question number 16 is account. Question number 17. A company which can offer its shares for subscription to the public is known as. A company which can offer its shares for subscription to the public is known as. And the correct, the options are private company, public limited company, public corporation, and corporation. And the correct option is public corporation. Question number 18. What is the other name of authorized capital? What is the other name of authorized capital? And the options are issued capital, nominal capital, uncalled capital, and called in arrears. And the correct option is nominal capital. Question number 19. The debenture interest paid is recorded in which part of the final accounts of a limited company? The debenture interest paid is recorded in which part of the final accounts of a limited company? And the options are trading account, profit and loss account, profit and loss appropriation account, and the last one, balance sheet. And from these options, the correct option is profit and loss account. Question number 20th, and this one is the last question. The dividend is calculated on which of the following values of shares? The dividend is calculated on which of the following values of shares? And the options are authorized share capital, issued share capital, called up share capital, and paid up share capital. And from these four options, we guys have to find out one correct option. And what will be the correct option? And the correct option is paid up share capital. on paid up value of share capital, we always calculate the amount of dividend at the end of the year. So this is for the questions or MCQ questions of topic number 2, accounts of final accounts of companies. So here we have done with at the time of leaving. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon so that you will get this kind of videos in days to come. Also don't forget to like, share, and most important, don't forget to write your comment in chat box so that I can improve in my videos. Thank you very much. See you in next video.